My startup is failing, partners leaving, $20,000 buyouts, cars being stolen, sleeping on basement floors, and million-dollar business deals. Last August, I partnered up with two brothers to build a Turo rental car business from the ground up, and in that time, a lot has happened.
Ladies and gentlemen, I just made it to the Denver airport, the top G's in town, and we're here to save this Turo startup. But while we wait for the shuttle bus to pick me up and bring me to the rental car, let me bring you guys up to speed with the last update video 4 months ago. At that time, things were going well. We were nearing up on 30 Turo cars. We hired a couple employees to help with car maintenance and cleaning. Guests were leaving great reviews. Revenue figures were at all-time highs. And our entire system for managing cars seemed almost complete.
But then after a meeting with our accountant,
on ongoing expenses, we're like $23,000 negative.
Things changed.
Going into this meeting, Chris, Aaron, and I all have two questions. Number one, have our clients been making money these past few months? And have we been making money? Especially on the company profitability side, I kind of have a feeling how it's gonna go, but nonetheless, let's hop on this meeting.
You had gross profit at $82,000, but then you had expenses of $51,000. That gives us net income of $32,297.88.
To profit $30,000 in the first year of a business with multiple employees isn't bad, but some months we actually lose money.
This is November and this is December. You actually had a loss in December. So you want to leave some money in the bank in case you have some other months that are slower.
And that's because a lot of the profit we make is from adding cars to the fleet, since we charge an initial setup fee to find the customer a car and get it set up on Turo with photos, building out the listing, and also setting it up on insurance. But when it comes to managing cars, our margins are very thin, since we take a 30% cut on whatever the cars make, and let's say in an average month where our clients have $30,000 in earnings, we get about $9,000 of that. That $9,000 sounds like a lot, but trying to scale the business, we have cleaners hired, we have to pay for parking at the airport, and we have a full-time employee, Megan, who we pay. So the months we had less cars to the fleet are low profit, in some cases losing money, whereas the months like October, where we add a whole shipment of cars, made us $10,000 in profit.
Can we sustain this once you quit adding cars? Because it's presumably at some point, you're not going to want to continue to add cars. Since we were bringing on cars, you made money, you know, you had 55, but on ongoing expenses, we're like $23,000 negative, of which the clients paid like $12,000 towards that expense.
So in the company's lifetime, we've earned a profit of $50,000 adding cars to the fleet, but lost about $15,000 in ongoing management. But with this information presented, it's time to figure out, are our clients making money?
So our accountant Denise just sent us statements for each client, and I'm not gonna lie, on average, it looks pretty good.
A lot of our clients are profiting up to $1,000 per month. Like Chris himself is a client of our business, and his Toyota Highlander made $1,952 in revenue, and after the management fee and expenses, he took home $1,045.70. Another client, Sabrina, took home $616, but she did have a maintenance fee. Kent took home $2,610.97 in January from two cars, and they revenued about $4,000. I will say, Denver is a really good market for Turo. It's one of the only places I've seen cars like a Nissan Murano revenue as high as $2,000 per month, and I think part of that also is we offer one-day trips. A lot of Turo hosts with multiple cars do three-day trip minimums, and that will affect your utilization and how much you can charge a day by far. But I think the high Turo revenue on average, combined with us getting clients reliable cars at fair, if not below market prices, makes our services worth it for them. But now comes the question, how are we gonna fix this company? Well, shortly after this meeting with our accountant, Chris decided to leave the business because at this point it was clear that the sales side of the business and onboarding cars was pretty much buttoned up, but the management needed, well, a lot of work. I think Chris also wanted to focus his efforts more on real estate, since for those of you who don't know, he has multiple properties that he rents out. And I think he saw more of an ROI focusing on that versus managing a Turo fleet. So he got paid out for 35% of his equity at a little over $15,000. And Chris still retains 5% equity in Arslan Fleet for all of his hard work. And we're still homies, guys, so no hard feelings. But now that you're brought up to speed with the company situation, this was my trip to Denver, Colorado.
Thank you for the ride.
As you guys can tell, we made it to the airport parking lot. We store our Turo cars.
But over here in section Z4 is where we park all our Turo cars. This Tesla in front of me is actually one of our newest additions. We have two Teslas now, and looking at this car, it's absolutely beautiful. It rents for well over $100 a day, and it's booked out like all the time.
I wish this was the car I was renting this week. The car I'm renting is Aaron's Jeep Wrangler, probably one of my favorite cars on the fleet. And when you look at it, you guys might notice there's no lockbox on the outside of the car. And that's actually because we now have the remote unlock feature on most of our Turo cars, and all you need to do is Aaron sends you a link on Turo, you click ticket. It takes you to a website, and then we're gonna go ahead and press unlock, and the GPS we have installed in this car should hopefully work.
There we go. And boom, right in front of me, we have our Jeep.
And now that we got our Turo car, I'm gonna go meet up with Aaron and Megan to go look at a potential parking lot that we wanna buy, since paying this $8 parking for each car kinda adds up.
Bro, this Jeep is awesome. I don't think I've ever driven a Jeep before.
We just made it to the potential Turo parking lot, and I believe Aaron is in this car right here. We have a puppy, and we have Aaron Arslan. So right here, we have the potential parking lot for our Turo cars. And the thing that I think is super awesome about this location is right up there is an enterprise. So one rental company already has land right around here. That means we probably should too, huh?
Yeah, I mean, it's zoned for the right things. It's zoned for having a rental company. We could even do the maintenance at the lot, which would make things way easier and more efficient for us.
The other lot we're at, we're not allowed to do maintenance on the cars there, and we just got yelled at today for cleaning our cars at the lot when I was filming content with our cleaner Izzy. So right here, we got the car detailer. You said you've watched my channel before,
yes,
right?
Yes, yes. I'm a subscriber, been a subscriber for quite some time now.
Do you have any work you have to do right now at the airport?
I do, so I'm gonna be focusing on this Tesla here in a bit.
While Izzy was wiping down the Tesla, security pulled up.
The Turo car?
No, we're just hanging out.
So cleaning is prohibited in these lots.
We weren't cleaning.
What are the cleaning supplies for?
He was just showing me his supplies. Deny, deny, deny.
Read the contract.
Okay. Are you gonna like arrest us?
Are you serious?
With high-level federal agents onto us, cars being stolen from the lot, and the daily parking fee, it's time for us to find somewhere else to store our vehicles. But the issue is, the parking lot we looked at is $900,000. We definitely don't have that kind of money right now, and that doesn't even include the cost to put a fence around the lot. Add some gravel, we're probably looking at like $1 million plus. But we're gonna keep looking at other options, even if it means renting a lot for a fixed amount that we're allowed to do cleaning and maintenance from. But with that being said, probably the biggest reason we don't like our current airport lot is in a recent video, two of our cars got stolen, a $40,000 Jeep and a very nice Lexus. Luckily, both of the cars were recovered, and to my surprise, the Jeep just had a broken window that's now fixed, and the Lexus had almost no damage. Last year, over 35,000 cars were stolen in the Denver area, and especially when we had lockboxes on our windows, we were massive targets. Luckily now, we've swapped out all of our window lockboxes with $100 remote GPSs, but unfortunately, before we were able to do so on one of our final cars, it got taken from the airport. And I got the entire situation from us finding out about the stolen car.
And the GPS was disconnected, so that tells me that it was stolen.
To calling the police caught on camera. And things started out as just a normal day managing cars where I got to drive a Tesla. We just made it to the airport parking lot, and not only are we gonna drop off the Murano, I'm actually going to be driving that Tesla up there. I'm not sure if you guys can see it, but as I mentioned earlier, we had a client who gave us two Teslas to manage for him, and I've only driven a Tesla a handful of times. Do you trust me to drive the Tesla, bro?
Guess we'll have to.
I'm kind of excited. I hope the door's open. Oh, damn. This Tesla is sick. I believe it is a Model S. It's a super nice car. Oh my God. Oh shit. There is the second Tesla right there. Aaron is gonna be taking that one. Because we had to take the Teslas to go charge. One thing about electric cars is you gotta plug them in.
Let me get a little plug and plug it into my Tesla. Maybe I can get an erection one day. Is this the man you are?
But on the way to plug in the Tesla Model Y, we went to check on our Subaru Crosstrek since it had a trip coming soon, but that's where we found out it was gone.
Did you see the Crosstrek at all when you were at the lot?
I started by calling our cleaner Izzy to see if he saw the car recently. Nada.
We'll keep you updated. I'll probably give you a call in a bit if we can't find it.
It does have some hard braking. It's got rapid acceleration. I mean, to be fair, they kind of get driven around crazy regardless. And the GPS was disconnected, so that tells me that it was stolen.
Be honest, bro. Are you tripping right now?
It's just a headache. It's just annoying.
We got to make sure this doesn't happen again. All of our cars other than this one are set pretty much. We have three GPSs in every car, but that one we haven't added to yet.
That
terrible.
That one needed to go to the mechanic. That's what we were literally picking it up to do, and then he was gonna install the GPS and everything.
This is not good, guys, but while we figure everything out, I'm gonna take the Tesla to go get some supercharging since it has 17% left and a guest is renting it out literally tomorrow. At the supercharger, we called our client to let them know about their vehicle being stolen.
I said, thank you for being so understanding. We'll definitely get some bottom of this.
And then with them, we contacted the police.
The theft happened yesterday. It was discovered 2 hours ago.
2 weeks later, the car's still not been recovered. But I don't wanna end this video on
on a negative note. There are definitely a lot of reasons I decided to stay with this business despite its issues in its first year. You have to think, it's kind of crazy how many cars we manage for just being in business for less than a year, and I think a major issue we faced was hiring the right people.
If you look at our previous videos, you'll notice we have different employees in literally every single one of them, and I think a big mistake we made in the beginning was hiring too many people too fast to a point where we couldn't afford it. But I think now we have a small but really good team, and Aaron is working super hard to cut costs so we're consistently profitable. We're also working on a bunch of exciting things like a car GPS, not only for our personal fleet, but for other Turo hosts to use, since it'll be a discreet device with a kill switch, and it'll also more easily track your vehicle. The link to pre-order that will be down below in the description, along with my new Discord server, Hustle World, that features exclusive content and podcasts every week. So check those links out down below, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out.